Hi, it's Denise. I'm sorry for the delay in getting you the instructions on how to use these incredible little products called force pedals. I actually spent about 3 years trying to build my own force pedals. So I'm just going to take it out here for you. And you can see, basically, it's this hexagonal shape that is really the fantastic thing about them. Now, what I did was I cut up foam rubbers, I cut up squash balls, trying to get all this to happen. And in the end, I would have been much better off just paying to get them straight off. So they were invented by Mike Adams and his biomechanical team. And I did some training, quite a bit of training with Mike, and now all my students go through Mike Adams Bioswing Biomechanics before I give them any golf lesson whatsoever. So that means there's about 8 screenings. I need to know what shaft plane they need to be on, where their right hand should release from, where they pivot from, a 2-plane swing, 1-plane swing, a whole lot of things that these biomechanical screenings do. But these force pedals are just amazing, because what these force pedals actually do is they help you use ground force, they help you use vertical force. The one I'm going to recommend most of my students use to start with is the orange force pedal, which is a little softer. I'll do some more videos later. This one is harder. This one has more rebound because it's much harder to press down. You can also use this one and the orange one under your right foot if you're a right-handed person. But what we're wanting to do to start with is use them. Number one, use them on the left foot. So let me just show you what we're going to do here. I'll just put this away. So I hope you can see here. What I'm going to do is place this orange force pedal under the ball of my left foot. I just want it pretty well even there. So just sort of on the toe there. That's the best place for it to go, depending on your biomechanics, but that is generally where we want it to go. I'll just put this one down here. And what I'm going to do, I'm just going to move it over. The first thing I want you to do is I want you to stand and use pressure. So pressure simply means I'm going to push into the pedal. I don't know if you can see it, but I'm squashing it down. I'll do a close-up later so you can see that I'm actually squashing into the pedal. What I don't want to do is I don't want to put all my centre of mass over onto it. That's no good for the golf swing if my centre of mass goes onto this pedal. So the step one is learn to find out what force is. You'll notice here I'm staying and I'm pushing. I'm pushing. You can see I'm squashing that. Next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to swing to the top of my backswing, and the first movement I'm going to push and I have a downward force into that orange pedal. Downward force. You can see I've really squashed it there. And when I'm squashing it, it's then going to rebound. So as I'm doing this, I'm pushing down. So it's one of Newton's laws. You're pushing down, equal and opposite reaction. The ground is going to help you. Just as if we were going to jump, the first thing we push down and we jump off the ground. That's what you need to be doing here. That's why you see a lot of the younger pros, really, they get so much power because they're using rotational force, vertical force and horizontal force, but they're using the right combination for them. So let's have a little look again. I hope you can see it there. So I'm swinging back. One push, two, three. You can see my hands have just dropped inside. From here I'm going to release the club head, and when I release the club head, it pushes the pressure back into my heel. I don't want to push down and stay down because I'll have that collapse view. So I'm at the top, pushing down into the ground there, into the ground. From here, I'm releasing the club head, which releases my body, and the pressure moves back. What most golfers will do is, their first movement, they'll come out this way. As soon as we do that, we're not getting the vertical force into the ball of the foot, it's going into the heel, which is one of the main reasons that everyone, or a lot of people, tend to come this way. When I'm doing that, the pressure is moving not into the orange pedal, but back into the heel. So it's push down, then you're going to release through. So that's the best way, I think, to start with. The first exercise, two exercises I'd have you doing with the force pedal. Orange pedal first, under there. If you find that that's really working, you can then use the yellow one. So try that. Let me know how it's going, and I look forward to seeing you soon. Remember, follow me on Skillist. Just go onto my profile, put follow, and you'll get all the latest videos as well and anything else, and we can have a chat that way. Good luck with your golf. Get these force pedals. If you want them, I do have some available. You can go onto Pro Golf Gals also and have a look at the